guys. I really don't know how I really want to start this vlog off, but I just decided, literally just at this moment, decided and said, you know what, Kenya, vlog, because you ain't putting up no content, so vlog. And I don't want to lose y'all. So, oh my gosh, I look like crap. I just got back in the house from picking up the kids from school. What I did all day? Nothing. I slept all day, y'all. I know it sounds pathetic, but I slept all day. It wasn't intentional, but I just slept. Anywho, so yeah, I really did. I slept all day. I decided to walk.
I'm trying to think of any other time that I was like super embarrassed.
I was watching Nikki Glam, her story time, and it started freezing. And I just like, all right, let me pick up the camera. And now it wants to start playing. So you're going to have to wait, Nikki. I'm sorry. You're going to have to wait. But I walked the kids to school this morning. And then when I got back, I just said, you know what? Can you lay down? Lay down. Go to sleep. Take a little cat nap. And the cat nap turned into a whole damn horse nap. Let me get up. So, just pick all the kids up from school. And they're eating, as always. Eating.
I have ice cream. This is my second time.
It don't matter. Stop using your fingers. It's nasty.
I'm sorry. I like to eat chocolate first.
That's what you got teeth for.
But I don't want to mess up the shape of it.
Mom, you're going to eat it anyways.
Disgusting.
Mom!
But I'm going to, for dinner, it's going to be, I don't know what is it called. Sausage something. With the sausage and potatoes. That's what I'm making.
It's only sausage and potatoes?
What did I make before? Wasn't it sausage, potatoes, and what?
Oh,
what else was in there?
What was that big, the big pan?
Yeah, but I'm trying to remember, like, what all I made with it. Sausage, potatoes, and what? Other than the vegetables, what else I put in there? I don't remember putting nothing else bacon. In there. I ain't put no bacon. Damn bacon. Girl, lying so much.
Why? It's nasty.
Sausage, bacon, and potatoes. Girl.
Eggs.
No. I did not put no eggs. Stop lying.
She's thinking of breakfast.
Listen, stop lying, for real. I'm trying to remember.
Ice cream.
Mom, do you realize nobody's laughing?
You stop the.
All right.
Mom, this girl just put the whole ice cream thing in her mouth and it said, like, I was like, how you fit it in there?
Stop it. All right.
You want to get all of me.
But that's what I'm making for dinner. I'm going to be using the Garcia sausages. Some Garcia sausage with some potatoes and season it all. I'll show you guys how I make it, whatever. But I don't know. I feel like I want to add something else in there. Could I add some shrimp in there? Would that be nasty if I add shrimp in there? Kamara, stop it. I'm not playing. I'm trying to remember what I put in there for real. I'm cut up some vegetables and stuff, but I'm trying to remember. I didn't put no shrimp. It was just the potatoes and the sausage. I'm tripping. Like, I don't know why I'm seeing something else.
I'm seeing carrots. I don't know why.
No, I didn't put no carrots in there.
Oh, you had peppers.
Yeah, I had peppers. I said other than the vegetables. Oh. Trying to remember what else I put in there. Ding, ding, ding. Nah. I think tomatoes, yeah, went in there as, like, a part of the vegetables or whatever, but...
Oh,
I was like, I don't remember. I made it, like, once or twice or three times. I don't know. I made it, but it's been a while since I made it, so that's why I don't remember, like, what... yeah, go ahead. Eat the pizza. Go ahead. I knew that's one. It's four in there, right? Four, child. Is how many kids in this house? Four.
One.
You want to say it's one? I'll shut you down because I'll be the one. And nobody will get a slice of pizza.
Mommy!
Tell your sister don't be trying me like that then. But I'm about to, I guess, like I said, I just got home, so they're going to eat a little snack. Normally, when they get home, they eat a snack. And then I help the boys out with their homework. They're in the room changing their clothes real quick, help them out with their homework, and then get to starting dinner. And I guess when I start dinner, or like, I don't know, I'll be back in a minute. Just give me a second. Give me a second. See how I'm going to operate this whole thing right now.
Nintendo.
You got homework, buddy. You got homework. So even though you're not hungry, you still got to do your homework. So put those toys back. Put them back. And get the book bag out the middle of the floor. I think it's your brother's book bag. I'm sorry, but you got to put that back. You sure you're not hungry?
No.
Okay, so that means you're not going to ask me for nothing, right? Right? Right?
Yes.
Oh, okay. That last slice of pizza was supposed to be for a ton, but he says he's not hungry, so I guess I'll just eat it. It's just there, whatever. But he still got homework to do. There's two things that cannot last in my house more than a week. Okay? Two things. Ice cream and bananas. Cannot last in my house more than a week. It is gone. Okay, so pause for a second. I can't be the only mom that's going through this. Please comment down below. If you have a child that goes to school with the pencil in their book bag and comes back home every day without it, I have came to the conclusion that they have to be eating it, or they just out there passing out pencils to their friends. I just don't get it. At the beginning of the year, I racked up on pencils and pencils because I know this is an ongoing thing. I would put 3 to 5 pencils in their pencil case, and they will come home every day with one less until it's completely gone. And I just don't understand. I told them, like, do not give away your things. Like, other kids have parents that's supposed to be responsible for making sure that their child have the utensils and everything for school.
Guys.
But why is it that my child have to provide for your child? Your child coming to school, because they tell me all the time, oh, this person just went in my pencil case and took it. That person, I'm like, don't let them do that. I'm sorry, but sharing is caring, but not when I got to keep digging in my pocket for other people I don't even know that don't even live in my house. I'm sorry, but I cannot continue to supply the school with pencils when my child don't have, like, right now the year's not even out and I'm out of pencils. I'm out of pencils, y'all. I'm out of pencils. And they keep coming home with all these different color pencils that I did not purchase at all. Like, look at this one. This blue pencil. I don't know where this came from. I have never purchased no blue pencils for them. Only these. And I don't understand where they at. I don't understand. Look at this pencil case. You talking about pencil, you talking about crayons, Everything. It's always getting smaller and smaller and smaller. I don't get it. Give me that. Look, and then these cray cray pencils that I honestly don't understand. Like, is this a number two? This is not a number two. That's why. This is not even a pencil that I purchased with my money. The ones that you got to keep sharpening for days until you get a lead that's going to stick for them to use. Last night, I sharpened and sharpened and sharpened, and it just kept falling out. And I just sharpened this a while ago saying, all right, here you go. I'm not even going to go any further because, you know, sometimes you want that pointy tip, but sometimes it's like, forget the pointy tip. Just write. It'll eventually get pointy. But he just picked it up to use it, and it just fell out. I'm so sick of this. I'm so sick of these pencils. I'm so sick of this whole problem. Now he got to do his homework. He's sitting here to do his homework. And look at this, y'all. Look at this. Little pencil case. This is ridiculous. Yeah, so they about to do their homework. This is an everyday thing, y'all. Everyday routine thing for me that I have to do every day. It's a mom. And, yeah.
Every day we win. Every day we win.
You gonna hit your head on the back of this dang wall.
That was ridiculous. Like my hairstyle though.
Boy.
Mom, these. A blue version of that sharpener.
I need a pencil. Sharpened.
There was a blue version.
I need a blue. You hear me talking? I need a blue. Alright, I'm done. I'm sorry, this eye look kind of watery. I have in, these are fall, these are individual lashes.
Wait!
I know this girl did not just run and say that while I'm recording. Like, you lost your mind. Go and take a shower, please. Or go do what you're supposed to be doing in that bathroom.
Sorry.
But yeah, I'm done. I gotta, what am I about to say? She literally made me lose my whole train of thought. Yeah. So, I'm done helping them. But this lighting is so terrible. That's kind of better. So I'm done helping them with their homework. One thing I don't like about with their homework is that they're in the same grade, but they come home with two different homework. So I'm like going back and forth, helping with this and that. And then sometimes like whatever one get, the other one would get like on another day. So I'm like, didn't I see this already? But if you didn't know, by the way, I have twin boys. They're twins. So they're in the same grade and they... You know, like I said, they get homework and it's two different homeworks. So they teachers, two different teachers, of course. And I'd be like, I wish that I could, y'all just got the same homework when y'all came home. That way I could just like help both of y'all out at the same time and just be over with and done with the homework. So it's crazy. But yep, I'm done with them. And now I gotta move on. I'm sorry, I keep moving the camera. I gotta move on to go help. I gotta go start dinner. It's like 4:47, but I really don't start dinner like this early, honestly, because we eat dinner about 6:30, 7 the latest, and they're in bed by 8. So I would typically start making dinner about 5:30. What I'm making tonight is gonna take I'd rather let it stay in there for about an hour. So I try to time. When I'm making dinner, I try to time it or whatever. Yep. Why are you going through her bag?
Her phone was ringing.
Speaking of phone, where my phone at? And if you're wondering where my spouse is at, he is at work, unfortunately, because of the job that he has. You don't really see him that much. So, yeah, he's gone back to work. So it's just me and the kids. So this is just my normal thing when I do when it's just me and the kids. You know, I just try to get everything running smooth. It's five of us in here. One adult, four kids. And it can get a little hectic sometimes. It can. I ain't gonna lie. It can. But the older that, like, the girls get, it's become a lot easier for me. But they can still be a little hard-headed sometimes. And be real. They can. But I get things going when need to. So this is pretty much it for the night, though. Like, it ain't really much to do. Their homework was pretty easy. I don't really need to help the girls with their homework. I just go over it with them. If they need help, they'll ask me for help. If not, it's just really the boys that I have to deal with when it comes to homework. And I just need to get dinner going. What else? When it comes to dinner, I would try to make two nights worth, because I don't like cooking every night. I don't know about y'all, but I do not like cooking every single night. So sometimes I would try to make, like, whatever I made last night. But then the older that the kids get, it's kind of hard to do that. It's very, very hard to do that, by the way, because it's always, they want seconds. And then it's like, it used to be easier when, you know, they only took one servings, and then the rest would be left for the next day. But now they're like, they want two servings, or they want extra chicken or extra rice, extra whatever. And that what you thought was going to be leftovers for the next day, it's gone. So I end up having to cook, like, probably four times out of the week. And that's not bad. But some days it would be them finding something for themselves to eat. As far as, like, I would go grocery shopping and buy things for me that I have to cook. And then things that I don't have to cook, that they can go in there and fix it themselves. So that's a little tip for people who have, like, older kids, or you, like, have a house full. Like, you don't have to cook every single night unless you just that type of person. But me, sweetheart, no, I do not like cooking every single night. So some nights it's like, I'll tell them, like, hey, go ahead and fix yourself something to eat. And when I talk about fixing something to eat, I'm talking about, like, especially like Fridays, Saturdays, I'll tell them, like, you know, have hot dogs. I'll buy, like, French fries, hot dogs, or, like, burgers and stuff like that. And they can make that themselves using a griddle. Or my oldest, she's old enough, she's 11, so she can fix herself some things, or she can fix all her siblings some things to eat. And that takes, like, a load off of me for the like, couple days or whatever. So I love that. But I don't think what I'm making tonight, I don't think I can, that's going to be two servings. I think that's going to be, like, it's going to be a little bit left over, but it's not going to be enough for everybody. It's a lot of us in here, y'all. It's five of us, so. And the older the boys get, the faster their metabolisms are, like, so fast. So they eat and the food just, like, goes away and they're coming back for more. So they go to bed at 8 o'clock at night. So that's why I like to, like, let them eat, like, 6:30 to 7 o'clock. And when they go to sleep, you know, the food is not just sitting there, but at least it gets time to go down. And they can at least, like, not go, you know, don't go to bed hungry is the whole point. But I don't like for them to snack before dinner. That's one thing I don't like to do, because I want to make sure that they eat. I would hate to be in that kitchen for damn hours, and then when you put the food in front of them, they're like, oh, I don't want any more. You don't what? That bothers me so much. So I like, when they come home from school, you get one or two snacks, and then you just wait. Get something to drink, get out the kitchen, and wait for dinner. So to ensure that when dinner time comes, they eat their food. So, I think that's about it. So in a minute, it's about 4:57. So in a minute, then I'm about to go and start cooking, like peeling the potatoes and all of that. And cutting up the vegetables. And I think I'm going to show you guys how and what I'm talking about, what I'm going to make. I got this idea from, you know, on Facebook, when they all, you go to Facebook and they have, like, little recipes or little, like, things, ads that pops up every now and again. So I got the recipe. I love when those ads pop up. I love seeing new ideas. And I surely love to save them until, you know, that day when I'm like, what the freak am I going to make for dinner? And boom, there it goes. So, oh, gosh. So, yeah, that's what I'm going to do. I'm probably going to listen. What's wrong with my knee? I'm not talking right. Like, this is so annoying. My tongue just keeps, like, being lazy as heck right now. But, yeah, I think the girls are taking showers now. So, get that out the way. And I think that's all I got to say right now. Let's get to the next clip. You'll see will probably be me in the kitchen fixing dinner. Pretty much.
Potatoes give peel. Guys, let me know if potatoes get peeled, what do they taste like? Okay, guys. Okay, good. You get a thumbs up.
This is the finishing product. It is done. I just got to mix it up a little bit. A lot of the juice is at the bottom, so I just got to toss it around and serve it.
No.
All right, so I'm done. Everybody is at the table getting ready to eat. This is everybody serving, getting ready to eat. Mine is over there. And I think I'm going to go ahead and just end the vlog right here. Because after we're done, the boys have already taken a bath. Colton, chill out. The boys have already taken... Everybody has already taken a bath except for me. So after I'm done with this, we're just going to clean up. They're going to head to bed. And I'm going to clean up the kitchen. And that's going to be it for me. So I'm going to go ahead and end the vlog. If you want to see more vlogs like this, go ahead and comment down below. Let me know how you like it. If it was cool. Like... Some feedback. All right.
Peace.
No, I don't ever say peace.
Toodles.
Toodles.